Welcome back to Let's Play Mass Effect Andromeda. I'm the RPG chick. We have a few more things to do before the game is done. Believe it or not, we got this meet Drac on the Nexus, and we have another interview with Carrie Tavessa on the Nexus. And we're all supposed to return to Habitat 7 in the Ericsson system. Maybe that's 100% viability as well. So yeah, we're going to the Nexus first. Curious to see what will go on here. This Ericsson. So I'm kind of wondering if we're going to walk around the Nexus and everyone's going to be seeing different things. And I'm wondering how far I should go in talking to everybody. I mean, if they're all going to say different things, I wonder if they all say different things. Like, should I really go to all the settlements and ask people? Talk to people? I don't know. Not sure if it would be worth it. This is our, well, it should be our final voyage to the Nexus. Voyage, visit, victorious visit. So I'm gonna check in with Tian and Cash and all them, of course. I'm sure they'll have some lines. I can't believe you said that.
Recovered in deep space after nearly being destroyed during a Ket assault. The Lucinia was mostly evacuated by the time initiative forces intercepted the Ark in the Valais system. This after the Asari Pathfinder, Matriarch Ashara, was killed while attempting negotiations with the Ket. A decision by replacement Pathfinder Sarissa Theris to prioritize Ket data over Ashara's life was condemned by Asari leadership. Theris has since been stripped of her title and replaced by her second-in-command, Vidaria Damali. This is
HNS. Okay. Nexus, condition upgraded. Specialist Scott Ryder is reportedly in stable condition after helping stop the Archon and secure Meridian. Doctors expect the human Pathfinder's brother to make a full recovery. So, not unsurprisingly, he is also human. Meridian Ket routed. Meridian found. The Ket defeated. Meridian found. In a dramatic battle that killed the Archon, I guess, the mysterious remnant technology known as Meridian was activated. While the limits of its power are still unknown, the effects are widespread, making any world with a vault not only livable, but sustainable. The Hyperion was nearly lost in battle with the Archon, but thanks to the bravery of the Ark's pilot, Captain Dunn, its estimated 20,000 passengers in stasis survived a crash landing. Species across the galaxy are heralding the decisive victory over the Ket as a major step toward galactic unity. Nexus ambassador named. Moshai Sfefa, how do you say that? Sfefa, has been named interim ambassador to the Nexus. The appointment of the Angaran leader is heralded as a smart political move, given the Milky Way species' alien status in Helios. Okay. Hi. Can I hide with you? I'll just go over here. Okay. Hello? I saved the cluster.
Ridiculous. Why would you say that?
Maybe he thought he was being honest.
Hello, this is Director Jared Ken. I would like to extend a warm welcome to all our Asari
All right.
Welcome to the next news.
Please help me.
Must be some meat Drac right there.
Alright.
He's up. He's up there. Alright.
At my age, family is more important than you experience.
These power.
Drac? Where are you? He's in. Oh, yeah. I was going to go see Drac. I didn't realize you were here. Strictly
the
professional.
Angara are survivors, and they're willing to help. They'll be great allies.
That's pretty random. Thank you. Yep.
You made it back. You always come back.
I'm glad you're okay.
I was worried about you after the Ket attack. I wasn't afraid of them, just afraid for you. Everything will change now. I want to start documenting Meridian, and I guess you'll be busy too.
Not everything will change. Not if we don't want it to.
Hey!
Well then, we'll both have something to hold on to.
No one say all that.
Meridian. Now that's history in the making.
I thought I was, like, being interviewed, no? Okay. I kind of wanted to, like, close it off with her, but I guess I don't have that option. Sup, Drac?
Everything's reading normal. They're snug as... Oh, hey, Ryder.
What's snug?
Harry, what's going on here?
His quads?
You're telling her? Oh, can I watch, please?
Oh, she's pregnant.
Of course.
Got something to show you.
A surprise?
I love surprises.
Look at Cash.
Wait. Are those...
Krogan children. My children. Live in the egg, every last one of them.
Nobody else knows, Ryder.
Awesome.
We're keeping this quiet after what happened with that human baby born out here. I don't know what's in store for me, but... However this turns out, I'll be part of our future. And so will you.
Do you want my help?
So, does that make me the godparent?
Don't let it get to your head. We're going to need more than one.
Hope. It's a scary thing. I'll teach them, Ryder, about what we used to be and what we are now.
Just like he taught me.
Awesome. Take that, Genophage. Wow. It's almost like it was a figment of my imagination. So what am I doing here? Is there anything else to do here? The journey so far. Nak Mordrac. Saving the galaxy from the Archon has given Drac a new sense of purpose. What's more, Drac has revealed he is going to be a great-grandfather. After so much struggle and strife, the Krogan may actually have a reason to be optimistic about their future in Andromeda. Yay! And let me guess. It's just this. Okay. Oh, I thought we might find one more remnant data core. Oh well. Let me go visit the directors. Because if anyone's going to have anything new to say, it's going to be them. And these are people just talking about power outages and stuff. I kind of wonder though. I don't think I can get in here. Isn't this the cultural exchange? Yeah. Oh, Jal's hanging out here. What's up, Jal?
How's the cultural study going, Jal? Read up on the Elcor Hamlet yet?
Yes. I think the performance certainly elevated the source material.
Mm-hmm.
Did you know that PB's father was an Elcor?
Yeah, that's... I don't know how that works, like, physically. Hello?
Hello again.
No, nothing, okay.
Thanks. Of course.
But of course. So you can't come out this way. Which is... Oh, all the way over here. Right? Yeah, you worry a lot. You say damage. Alright, let's go to operations. Go visit the directors one more time. Hopefully they will have something to say. Now the Hyperion is not here, so... Right. It still shows it here, but of course we can't go there. Unending daylight. Kandros?
Thanks for understanding about the outpost and the protesters.
You don't strike me as a political type.
I'm not. Just pro keeping everyone alive. Maybe those protesters will eventually understand too. It's done. I don't want to think about it. Need something else?
Nope.
Bye, Kandros. Duty calls.
You and me both, Pathfinder.
Alright, just check in with... what do I want to talk about them? I don't think they'll have anything new to say. I could be wrong, but...
Colonial Affairs, please advise Director Tan of your...
So... Let's talk to... Cash is in here, right?
I'm worried about this place if the Ket find you.
Then we defend the station. It's all we can do here. You just keep the Pathfinder safe and the Ket busy.
Who, me?
And be careful out there. I only have one of you.
She only has one of you.
Ark Parchero advises stasis revival...
Pathfinder!
...are proceeding.
Okay. Cash.
Things are going well. The outposts and resources you found have made a real difference. This place is starting to look the way it was always meant to.
Krogan colony resources?
It was you helping the Krogan colony smuggle resources back onto the station, wasn't it?
We Krogan are a hardy lot. We probably could have managed just fine on our own. In the short term. Long term, it's in our best interest that the station, and those on it, survive.
Well. Well, that was awesome.
Nothing more for now.
Later.
Laters.
Apex personnel, please check your duty roster.
Addison's office. You call this an office? It's like a just a platform.
Pathfinder, I'm enjoying Tan's ongoing discomfort with an Ungaran ambassador.
Oh, yeah?
Not that the Moshai would take advantage. Such base manipulation is beneath her. So, what can I do for you?
Nothing at all.
Director Addison.
Goodbye, Pathfinder.
Apex personnel, please check your duty roster for important updates.
Hello again. You should fix that thing. It's still sparking. I mean, you've done all these improvements. Yet still let that thing spark like that. Ager.
Ryder, I am in awe. Meridian found and the Archon no more. The vision of the initiative is taking root, thanks to you.
I had help, including you.
It was a team effort, and you're a part of that, Ager.
I did my small bit, I suppose. Reiko would be happy. Not satisfied, but happy.
Nice talking with you, Hager.
And with you, Ryder.
Hey, Cora. Just walk right through me.
Hi, Ryder.
Vidaria? Get over here.
You did it. All your hard work paid off, and now, Meridian.
Those Asari Huntresses made a difference. Thank you.
Of course. Feel that? It's like the whole initiative is resting easier thanks to you.
Okay. Bye.
Good luck, Pathfinder.
Goddess go with you.
From one Pathfinder to another.
How are things going with Ark Lucinia?
The Asari seem happy just to be...
Ryder, I won't pretend I'm not disappointed. I'd hoped your choice for ambassador would go... differently.
Too damn bad.
I called it as I saw it.
Well, at least you didn't pick Morda. A Krogan with power?
Oh god.
That's how wars are started.
I should have picked
her.
Did
you have some other business?
She was not one of the people you could pick. Nope.
That's all. Thanks for your time.
My pleasure. I see great things in our future.
So do I. Racism not being one of them. Okay, onward.
Any logistics updates are due within the hour.
Guess we're done. This way.
Maintenance crews, please report to the commissary. William Spender, assistant director of Colonial Affairs, has been fired after he was caught stealing supplies from the Nexus. Spender is currently in custody, awaiting disciplinary action. This is Agent S.
Shouldn't only be fired, he should be arrested.
Unknown, the effects are widespread, making any world with a vault not only livable, but sustainable. The Hyperion was nearly lost in battle with the Archon. But thanks to the bravery of the Ark's pilot, Captain Dunn, it's estimated 20,000 passengers in stasis survived a crash landing. Species across the galaxy are heralding the decisive victory over the Ket as a major step toward galactic unity. This is HNS.
Yay! Yeah, it was worth hearing. Basically the same thing I read aloud, though. Heading back for the Ericsson system. Habitat 7. Where everything began. Wow. I wonder what's in store.
Welcome back.
Thank you. More battles with Ket? Oh, we're gonna find a surprise there. Everyone's settled the place. And we're gonna have a surprise party. No idea. I'm pretty sure I didn't even have an option to even try to land here again. Yeah, not skipping this one. It's been long enough. We can let it play out. What's this? Another
thing? So, back at Habitat 7.
No.
What am I supposed to see, and what's it got to do with 100% viability?
I'm getting initiative signals.
magnetosphere charges, and atmosphere probes.
The vault here remains non-functional, but with 100% viability to invest, we've begun terraforming this world with initiative technology.
Hmm.
The good old-fashioned hard way. It'll eventually be a home too, thanks to you.
Thanks to us.
A team effort, surely.
There is one more item, Pathfinder. Opening channels to the Nexus, Meridian, Prodromos, Deteon, Tevuni, New Tachanka, and Initiative Allies. By unanimous vote, this world is to be renamed. Habitat 7 is now listed astronomically as Rider 1.
Really?
Your world, Pathfinder. Their future.
Seriously, though. That's a bit much, Rider 1, don't you think, Survey? Suvi?
What's going on?
I guess nothing.
I should get back to things. Sounds good.
Can I land there? Let me check my emails. Future out here, from Drac. Bear with me for a second. An old Krogan's about to get emotional. Not long ago, I honestly wondered why I'm still alive. There were so many times I almost bit it. A lot of those times, I deserved to. Somehow I kept living. Living so long, it's easy to feel like nothing matters anymore. Beyond maybe the smile I get, spotting a new scar in the mirror. But when I see all we've done, out here, Kesha's clutch, Meridian, suddenly the life I've burned and blown through has a real point. A reason to groan out of my bunk again and again. We're making everyone else's lives a little more worth living. Thanks for helping me see that, kid. Drac. Oh, you're welcome. Now, can we land there? There's a satellite. So I got nothing. You know what I'm wondering, though? I'm not going back to all these colonies. But... I want to take a look at these architects. I don't know, something else makes me want to check in on them, see if anything's gone. Because they're all like in standby mode. I'm wondering if they ever wake up or anything happens with them. Here's Ellen.
We're on course.
Interesting how they have it decommissioned and orbiting the planet, like not like the thing just blows up, like we literally just shoot the crap out of it and destroy it. It's different, though. It goes into orbit like that. Hmm. So... Rider 1, look at that. Anything else? The planet formerly known as Habitat 7 was one of the Golden Worlds selected by the Andromeda Initiative for early settlement. The first attempt to land there came at great cost, including the life of then-Pathfinder Alec Rider. but now, as a result of the perseverance of his daughter, the current human Pathfinder, the Initiative is returning to the planet. Pathfinder Ryder has achieved viability across Helios, gaining the resources for extraordinary efforts here. And to honor their achievement, the world has been renamed Ryder 1. Ryder 1 remains storm-racked with intense magnetic activity. The remnant vault on the planet is still non-functional, and restoring the network influence of Meridian has not changed that. But vaults are not the only means of making worlds livable. The Andromeda Initiative has begun traditional terraforming, starting with atmospheric manipulation to alter the climate. It is a lengthy and costly process, one that only 100% viability across the cluster has enabled. Ryder 1 will be a future golden world, developed from the ground up by the people whose children will eventually call it home. We have nothing. We have nothing, man. That's crazy. Okay. So I actually paused it because I was trying to think if there's anything else I should do. Anyone else I should check in on with, and I really don't think there is. So I want to thank you guys so much for watching. I've been playing Mass Effect games for the last, well, it's been well over, like, it's been a year and a half? I'm not even sure. It's been quite a while. I think it's been almost 2 years, actually. Mass Effect 1, 2, 3, and then this game. So, I had a hell of a time. Didn't enjoy this game as much, but still enjoyed it. I'm looking forward to, well, at least with this slot, getting back into getting medieval on your buttocks. So, anyone who's watching this currently, next up on this time slot, my first game of the day is Beyond Skyrim Bruma mod, and then Enderal, which is another mega mod. And tentatively, after Enderal, the entire Witcher series. So thanks so much, guys, for watching. Hope to see you in another Let's Play. And always, seek adventure.